Game Central readers reveal how much time they spend playing video games, from just a few hours a week to several every day. The subject for this week's hot topic was suggested by reader Wormwood, who asked whether you have a regular pattern for playing games and if there are particular days or times you set aside for them. Do you play more or less than in previous years, and do you worry that it's too much or too little? People's stories varied not only according to the time of year and weather, but also their age and responsibilities, and even how long their commute in. But almost everyone still said they wish they had more time. This is a tricky question, and to be honest, I'm not entirely sure I know. When I'm really into a game, like I have been with God of War recently, I can spend 4 or 5 hours a night. We have a separate TV room, man cave. That sounds like a lot, but I do try not to be antisocial with the girlfriend, and she understands that I'll only do it now and again when a big game comes out. But since games are so unevenly distributed throughout the year, this can become a bit tricky, so I have to sort of ration myself out so I get around to one about every 3 months or so. In between that, I will play but only an hour or two here and there on most multiplayer games. To me, that seems relatively healthy. We haven't had any big about it, and to be honest, I think it's good to get out of people's hair a bit now and then. Theoretically, I'd want more time, but I don't see how that's really physically possible. Not until I retire or something anyway. Then I realize I am probably one of the more extreme case for the amount of time spent gaming, as I spend at least 4 hours every day playing games and more at the weekend. That might seem like a lot, but most of the time my character is sitting around in a hub of an MMO while I talk to friends via the chat box. Of the 30 hours I spend weekly gaming, it's say 20 or so hours is spent chatting in an MMO. Of the rest, I spent the majority playing single-player games, Rime being my current game thanks to Origin Online, with a couple of hours playing mobile games mixed in. I'm not in front of the computer gaming all the time. I try to get out for at least an hour a day to get some exercise, but outside of work I'm lucky enough that I have plenty of time to indulge myself, so why not? Gymnasium is a good question because it's something I've been thinking about ever since the idea of spending more time reading about games than playing them came up. I definitely suffer from that problem, to the point where I'm essentially daydreaming about playing games I'll never really play. Sometimes I even buy them, but get time to enjoy them properly, that's rare. This is why I'm not sure about the games as a service idea. If you're an adult with a job, you're only going to have time for one or two of those at most, with no time for anything else. Which is fine if you're at the company making that one game, but what about the rest? Are we going to get to the point where there are only half a dozen major franchises? And everything else is indie games as a service may not be as greedy with money as loot boxes, but instead they're greedy with their time. Always publishers want something from you, whereas personally I just want to take when I have the time. Which is maybe an hour or two every other day at the moment. Psycho, email your comments to gamecentral@uckmetro.co.uk. I would say I probably play about 10 hours a week. Sometimes more if there's a big new game out or I'm stuck in the house, i.e. not now with this weather, but not often much less. I'm not sure whether that's a lot or not really, and I'm curious to see in the rest of the hot topic letters. I know I seem to be more into games than a lot of my mates, in that I know about them and keep up with the news and new releases, but a lot of the times they seem to spend a bit more time than me, but only on FIFA, Fortnite, Call of Duty and other ultra-casual games. I do play Fortnite occasionally, but I prefer single-player games and have recently completed the excellent new God of War game. It took me about 3 weeks of playing almost nothing but that, which is about right if you figure the average story game is around 20 to 30 hours if you try to do everything. Trepsels, my number is a bit skewed because I have a very long, almost 2 hours commute every day, and that's increasingly when I get the most time to play games. I started doing almost nothing but games on the train with the PS Vita, which I love and still get out occasionally. But increasingly, thanks to its equally good support for indie games, I've been using my Switch instead. It's a bit bigger than the Vita, so if it's a crowded train things can get a bit awkward, but the lack of compromise with the controls is more than worth it in my opinion. I don't tend to play big cinematic type games like Zelda, but more or less anything else is fair game, and I'm currently playing through Hollow Knight, which is fab. So averaging things out with maybe 5 extra hours in front of the big TV and the odd day when I don't have time, I'd say about 20 hours a week. That's not too bad, is it? Whereas I used to play games a lot when I was growing up, especially in my teens. I'm talking at least 4 or 5 hours a day. I found games like Final Fantasy VII and Resident Evil 1, 2, and 3 very absorbing, sometimes to the detriment of schoolwork and socializing with friends. Nowadays, with work and other responsibilities, I'm lucky to get 4 or 5 hours in a week, and that's only because I lose track of time and stay up way too late to the detriment of work. Nah, time flies when you're having fun. Stealth Reaper, catch up on every previous game's inbox here. I imagine you're going to get a lot of people complaining that they don't have as much time as they used to for games, and I think unless we have some 15-year-olds writing in, that's going to be true for everyone. I do think it is one of the big problems for gaming though, in that games take up more and more of your time and people have less to give of it. I'd say I maybe have 2 or 3 hours I can spare on gaming once or twice a week, and that's certainly not enough to get good at a multiplayer game. It also means the average single player takes me the best part of a month to get through. Just completed The Amazing Nier Automata on Xbox One. To be honest, I've almost given up on multiplayer games because of this and have switched in indie games instead as my other main source of gaming nourishment. It seems to me the video games industry is being split down the middle into the haves and have-nots, time that is. SMG, email your comments to gamecentral@uckmetro.co.uk. The small print new inbox updates appear twice daily, every weekday morning and afternoon. Letters are used on merit and may be edited for length. You can also submit your own 500 to 600 word four-player viewer features at any time, which if used will be shown in the next available weekend slot. If you need quick access to the Game Central channel page, please use www.metro.co.uk/games, and don't forget to follow us on Twitter.